Soon I left to be asleep, and she was deeply devoted to editorial independence, justice, transparency, democracy, and freedom of speech. She was a media freedom fighter. She lived with immense levels of fears, and she was terrified by the ongoing intimidation, but she was not cowed into silence. We all remember Sula for her great courage, principles, and passion. And despite the clear and deliberate intimidation and direct attacks on her personal and professional spaces, we will also remember Suna as an activist with heart and soul.
We are all indeed Suna Fenton. Our hearts are broken that 23 years into our democracy, we are fighting against censorship. It is exactly a year ago that we stood outside this very building, demanding an end to the tyranny that had befallen our beloved broadcaster. All she wanted was for the SABC to live up to its mandate, which is to advance the national and public interest. This week, I have been looking back at the pictures of journalists who stood united in not only the defense of our craft, but very aware that if we allow those that stand against our constitution to win, South Africa loses. Today, Suna, we are encouraged that we can speak of an SABC that is turning the corner. We find courage in Suna's indomitable spirit. They can call us names, claim we are captured, and even use race in a desperate attempt to silence the truth. As journalists, we don't take lightly our responsibility. We know the power of our words, but we also know our responsibility to South Africa. So to Suna's family, please find solace in that her cause was just. And it now rests in our shoulders. It rests on our shoulders. And we will continue her struggle. We are all Suna Fenton.